What's up with the status quo? The story begins in 1947 when Ben-Gurion proposes to the Haredi Agudat Israel that the state regulates Shabbat, Kashrut, and personal status. But over the past 70 years, the status quo has changed drastically. In 1951, the Knesset declared Shabbat to be a day of rest. 15 years later, it is expanded to include business owners. In 1987, Petah Tikva's mayor breaks ground by allowing cinemas to open on Shabbat. Meanwhile, kibbutzim develop thriving shopping centers that operate on Shabbat with the approval from the High Court of Justice. Let's see how the status quo has changed regarding marriage and divorce. In 1953, the rabbinate is granted a monopoly over marriage and divorce for Israeli Jews. 10 years later, the Supreme Court recognizes the civil marriages of Jews who marry abroad. Next, Israel's High Court grants common law couples equal status with legal marriages. In 2010, the Knesset cleared the way for civil marriage of non-Jewish Israelis. In 2013, marriages or divorces performed outside of the rabbinate become punishable by a 2-year prison sentence. And to the question of who is a Jew? In 1950, the Law of Return states that every Jew is entitled to immigrate to Israel. However, who is a Jew is never defined. In 1958, it is determined that anyone who declares themselves a Jew will be officially registered as such. It all changed in 1970, when it was decided that only a person born to a Jewish mother or who underwent an Orthodox conversion would be recognized as a Jew. In 1995, the High Court of Justice recognizes non-Orthodox conversions in Israel. In 2005, Israel's High Court recognizes conversions carried out abroad for purposes of obtaining citizenship. In 2016, the High Court of Justice breaks the rabbinate's monopoly by recognizing private Orthodox conversions performed in Israel. So, what remains of the status quo? Please comment and let us know what you think. Presented as food for thought by IDI.